Dark gray circles are inactive. Lit up and named circles can be chosen at any time. On the right bar is your critical clue list. This fills with data gathered from talking to the people involved with the case. These clues then must be found on location screens. Below is an area where you collect evidence. Once you receive all evidence you need from a particular case, the lab button appears. Click that to travel back to your lab to run scientific tests on the evidence acquired in the field. The case file button can be accessed anywhere in the field and is a handy journal of clues that should aid you if you get stuck. When moving the mouse around the screen, you will notice hover text pop-ups, giving you descriptions of the environment. Many times, these can indicate where to use inventory items or find difficult clues. If you think you're done here and want to check another location, remember you can go back and forth between available screens at any time. Be sure to click your map to leave this screen. 1. The field map screen is your main screen, and from it you can go back and forth to any other lit up location or talk interview. 2. You can use your hint button as much as you like, but it recharges slowly. There is no overall timer in this game, so relax and do a thorough job. 3. Exploring the screen with your mouse will reveal hover text that can guide you along your way, providing clues and descriptions of the environment. 4. Going back to the case file at any time to review your journal entries for helpful facts. 5. Click and drag inventory items over spots on the screen to try to use them. You might not need to use the inventory item right away, but may come in handy later in your field work. Welcome, new Monster Quest agent. You are about to embark on a series of investigations into cases of strange and mysterious creatures. Settle down in your office and read the material we've prepared for you at the beginning of each adventure. Pay attention. You'll need all of your wits about you to sort out the fact from fiction. Then get ready to travel to distant places, interview fascinating people, and discover the truth behind the legends. Good luck.
It's the Kraken. She has risen from the depths through the ages and taken many ships. The beast attacked a new young diver. I'd be happy to direct you to him, but I don't recall the fellow's name. The crew list is in the toolbox. The combo is written down someplace. If you could find the combo, it would help.
Thank you.
Here is his name, Rolly Tuscan. I'll warn you, he is pretty scared. I don't think you'll ever get him in the water again. That monster took a piece out of him, you know. Tore his suit to shreds.
I don't like to talk about it. It came up behind me while I was doing deep sea construction. I could feel it watching, then out of the blue it grabbed my arm. I used a wrench to beat it away, then I escaped. It ripped my dive suit. All this talk is bringing back that horrible day. I don't know. The ship's oceanographer took it. I don't ever want to see it again. It haunts me. I might if you can find the GPS coordinates. I don't know where we were. Dive gear and I'll take you out there, but I won't come with you. It's next to a bottomless pit filled with evil creatures. There are cameras recording the construction. Grab all the cameras and look at the film. You'll see what I mean.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, I heard a commotion, and I went out there and I found this thing rummaging in my chicken coop. It was wearing clothes, so I thought it was a man. I yelled, and it turned around, and I knew it was no man. It had teeth and patches of fur over all of its body. Go ahead and look. It was making a mess of my workshop. I scared it off. Help yourself to whatever you find. You're welcome to a dozen eggs if you can find any that aren't broken. Best eggs in Whittleton. Well, it wasn't a man or anything I've seen in these woods. Barry Winkler, the auto mechanic in town, says it was a werewolf. He has a car in his shop, he said, hit the same beast. Smashed the car up real good. You should talk with him. Werewolves, I don't believe in such stuff, but this thing did scare me.
Yeah, dude, don't know what it was, but they hit something big. Smashed the car up good. But it's not here, it's out getting its frame straightened. Yeah, sure. It was out on Highway 5. The tow driver said there are pieces of the car everywhere. Can you pick up a few missing parts? That car got smashed up pretty bad. I'm sure it was a werewolf, a big one. People all over town have seen it running around. Summer brings all kinds of people into the area. Could be anyone by day. That's the thing with the werewolf. Thank you.
Edgar and I were driving home in the evening when he nodded off. I wasn't paying attention, and we veered off the road. We swerved into the entrance to CK's campground, and were headed straight for this giant creature. Must have been 7 feet tall. We ran right into it. Then it ran off into the woods without a scratch on it. I don't know, and Edgar won't talk about it. He thinks it was some kind of creature. We are well respected here in the community, and my quilting club certainly wouldn't like a monster story. I'm a collector of all kinds of circus stuff. We're going to the circus again tomorrow, and I hope to pick up a few more things. Feel free to have a seat in the living room while I make some tea.
What? Look, man, I see strange things all the time. This is a circus. We have freaks and geeks. Can you tell me more? I've been with this circus since I was a kid. I know everything, in and out, and who and what. Nothing leaves without my knowledge. Werewolves? Seems a little far-fetched. Aren't werewolves myths? Tell you what, I'll give you the full tour of the circus grounds after I introduce the next act. This is a great show. You should check it out. Take a look around. Maybe you'll run into a vampire, too. Thank you.
was out in my boat with my brother when I felt a bump on the bottom of the boat. The creature's head rose up from the water and it was a terrible beast. My brother and I took off. I snapped a few quick pictures as we sped away. It was early morning, so it's kind of grainy, but you definitely see the monster. The monster is a very good omen to the people of the village. Everyone wants a copy of the photo. I have sold a lot of them. I think I have more in my garage. Take a look around. I just cleared it out and piled a bunch of junk in Rodrigo's dumpster. He owns the curio shop down the street. He is the real expert.
It is a beast sent to protect our village from evil spirits. It is powerful magic, and anyone that sees it is given good luck. I was on the beach one day after the storm and saw something moving in the storm pool on the beach. It was an infant creature. It was barely alive, so I brought the creature back to my home, but sadly it died. I have the skeleton in the case in the store. Businessman, and I cannot let you see the beast without something in trade. I would recommend going to the docks to Javier's store. I trade a lot of my favorite objects there. I traded Javier one of the prized El Monstro necklaces. Thank you. An El Monstro necklace. I sell them to people around town as a good luck charm. I took the scales off the skin of the dead creature. I would allow you to take a picture of the monster. Unfortunately, I do not have a camera. Perhaps you can find one before I close for the day.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.